I'm back.
Hey guys, I know it's been forever. And really probably don't have an excuse for that, but it's fine. Life happens. And to kick off me being back, I'm not doing anything special. I'm literally just getting ready for work, so I hope you're okay with that. And I'm just gonna talk to you a little bit about why I took such a long, long, long break. But that's fine. Hopefully it won't happen again. I'm gonna go in with this as my primer. It's the Pixi Glow Booster in Peach Gold. But yeah, so much has happened since my last video. Like, I'm pretty sure I don't even work at the same place anymore. I think during my last video, I still worked at Twin Peaks. That was a very short-lived. I only worked there like 2-3 months. And literally like the last couple weeks there, I cried every single day. Not there, but like at work, like in bed. Or not at work, but at home in bed. There we go. Just hated it. And now I work at a nightclub called Electric Cowboy. And if you live or have been to whatever, the like southeast region, I guess that's where they all are, I don't know, but of America, like I know there's some like in Texas and like Tennessee, I don't know. But yeah, that's where I work now. They do like line dancing and stuff like that, but it's like a club at the same time. It's weird, I don't know. Think like Coyote Ugly style, because we actually get up on like our little stage, like on the dance floor or whatever, and we like lead the dances. I don't know. For my work makeup, I literally like hardly wear anything, so don't expect anything special this time, sorry. But next I'm gonna get in with the Milani, the Concealer and Perfect Shine Proof Powder, and my shade is 05 Natural Beige. Now all of YouTube can hear our toilet flushing.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. Do you want to come sit and say hello? Why do you look so embarrassed?
I don't know.
Do you want to come sit with me while I get ready?
Can they see me?
Yes, they can see you.
Cool.
How does it make you feel?
That's the first time I've ever been on YouTube, I think.
So, what's it like? What's your first impression?
Cool, I guess.
World, this is my boyfriend, Christopher.
Hi, YouTube world.
Do you want to tell them how we met?
I was your boss. That's how we met. I started off training, and then true love.
Do you want to go into all the details?
No, I'll let you do that.
Why?
Because you probably tell it better than I do.
Why? Because I'm dramatic.
Yeah, I'll probably just be like, you tried to flirt with me. I didn't notice you. I was flirting in the face with your hair.
He didn't notice me!
I didn't notice you like that at first because I was trying to be professional.
To Hooters. That's not professional.
Yeah. You could probably tell the story better than I would, though.
It all started. On a cold, blistering... Oh, wait, that's completely opposite.
Yeah, it was like summertime. Blistering might be right, because it's so hot.
This is cold brew, by the way, not chocolate milk. You want to taste it?
No, I'm good.
He doesn't like coffee.
Nope.
How we live together, I don't know. Because coffee runs through these veins.
I'm gonna let you get back at it.
Why are you leaving me? Do you not like it? Do you not like being exploited?
What is that?
This is a contour kit.
Light to medium.
Because I'm a light to medium shade. I'm not deep.
What am I?
I'm about as pasty as it gets sometimes. I mean, you're medium-ish. Like, you've got a nice tan going on. Look at this. Like, he works outside and gets tan. I have to try really hard. But this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit. And Christopher, I'm going in with this yellow color right here. Taking the banana shade.
Why that shade?
Because I'm going to take this little Eco Tools brush. It's like a little tapered, floofy brush.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to take it and put it underneath my eyeballs and on my eyelid to make me not look so dead. See, look at that difference. See how much brighter underneath? Look like I had a nap, and this looks like a meth. This looks like a crack whore.
Up for 16 hours straight, just doing.
And it also acts as a base for my eyeshadow. What very little eyeshadow I wear to work, because I sweat a lot. Because I dance with spotlights on me.
I think this is the first time I watched up close you putting on makeup.
Oh my god, you should hang out for the whole thing. It's really exciting.
maybe next time.
Why?
I got some TV to watch.
Why?
Because I can't watch the shows that I watch with you around, because they're too much for you.
That's his way of telling everyone I'm a crybaby for being mean. And this
Too-Faced
is the Too-Faced Chocolate Soleil Bronzer. Surprise, surprise, this has been in every video since my very first video, basically.
It's about time you
got
a new one.
Look at how long it's lasted, though. Like, it just, I've had this 2.5 years, and I use it, like, every day. Like, this is my favorite bronzer. And it's still going, still trucking along like a freaking champ.
Alright.
What?
I was just watching.
I've told you what the purpose of that is, right?
That bronzer?
Yeah, what I just did.
I'm guessing you're defying your cheekbones?
Look, I didn't even have to tell him that!
We've watched a lot of makeup tutorials.
Oh yeah, that is true. He watches a lot with me. He knows everybody. Name off some gurus who we watch a lot. And I'm taking the same bronzer and I'm gonna contour my nose.
There's Jeffrey. There's Manny. I don't know her name. She just sings the intro to their subscribe song thing.
Laura Lee.
Yeah, there's that one. There's that Rachel one.
Rach Loves.
Those are the ones I know by name.
We watch a lot of Shannon, so he just does
that. Oh, yeah, that girl. That has the New Zealand accent.
Yep.
Yeah, there's that one. There's that other one that's from New Zealand, too, the...
Which one? Are you talking about the Soph Does Nails or
yeah,
whatever?
That one.
She's English.
Oh. Well, her accent sounds the same. Sorry if I offended anybody.
He just offended two entire countries.
I think it's my time to leave now.
No.
That's about all. Oh, then there's the Tati.
Tati Westbrook.
Yeah. You watch a lot of her.
I love her. I look up to her. I hope she sees this. I do. I think she's just, like, so beautiful, and I think, like, I want to look like her. I think I just ate some of this. I mean, if that's what I just tasted, it does taste like chocolate, if you're wondering.
I don't recommend eating it.
No, it's too expensive.
How much was that?
I mean, it's not like... crazy, but it's not cheap. I think this is like $30 or something. I don't remember because I've had this for 2.5 years and it keeps on going every day. No matter what, I contour my face, my nose, my boobs, all of this. And I still have a lot left.
All right.
Bet you didn't know I did that.
No, I didn't.
I do. How do you think I make them look so good for my jobs?
They just look good?
No, it's lots of push-up and padding and contour. But it's okay.
Thanks for hitting me in the face.
For my blush today, I'm gonna get in with this Milani. What the f***? This is just like a normal one. It's not baked or anything. Okay, it's just a normal one. It's got the little flower embossment or whatever. And this is number 11, Blossom Time Rose.
Mm-hmm. What's that do?
It's blush. Do you know what blush does?
Doesn't that go like on your cheeks or something?
Yeah, good job.
I just think of, when I think of blush, I think of like when people
when you're blushing.
Like, well, that too, but like you would see like the old makeup stuff and people would like their bright red on their cheeks.
Isn't he adorable? We watch a lot of Molly Burke.
Oh yeah, we just started watching her stuff.
Thanks to Shane Dawson for exposing her. Shane, please watch me too. Let's collab.
We watch a lot of him.
And I love Ryland, and I just love that whole crew.
I want to get along with Garrett.
I want to be in their friend group. Like, I wish we were friends with them. Garrett, we would be really good friends with Garrett.
Yeah.
And Morgan.
He likes Harry Potter and Marvel stuff, and that's what I'm into, so.
Exactly. We're all best friends. In my mind. And for highlighter, we're gonna go in with this poor abused soul, because it's my favorite highlighter ever and it's just destroyed. As a makeup, actually, you know what? I think I talked about this one before. Makeup Revolution strobe highlighter that you can't halfway see anymore. Literally, like, it's just falling apart. This is the shade Magnitude. Can I put highlighter on you?
No, I'm good. I don't want
to
show
you. You're not going anywhere. Oh, you're going to the gym later. Yep. Never mind.
Sorry, I guess you don't want to look pretty for the gym. No, I'm not one of those people who are posting all over the Instagram about gym. I'm actually trying to do something.
Here. Who's gym, huh?
It's this person that makes me sweat and kills me.
Oh.
That's gym.
Okay.
That's how I feel about him or her. It's 2018.
Might not even be a person.
No, might not even be a person. Might be an object. Gotta shine like Rudolph.
Oh god. I went in too much. You did this.
This is the Rudolph comment.
Oh, that was the that has shimmery stuff on it too.
I don't think YouTube's gonna like all the cussing.
It's okay, I know how to bleep stuff out.
Oh, okay.
I've done it on my videos plenty of times. Can I put makeup on you one day for this channel?
You're gonna do my makeup?
Yeah.
I got like half a face to do makeup on.
That's fine. We can put glitter in your beard.
What takes forever to get out?
I'll get it out.
You have a magic powder?
This poor highlighter though. I love it. It's so pretty. And I've been holding it together with a hair bow. I want more.
Shine extra bright today, tonight.
Yeah.
How long have you had that one?
Not that long, actually. You know that order that I did where I got most of it for like free?
Yeah.
That was from this. It's just, I've literally just used it to death that quick.
It looks like you've had it for like a good year and a half. It's just been damaged.
You heard it, people. That's how much she's used and abused. I just offended a lot of people too, it's okay.
You didn't offend two countries, so.
You did. Let's see, now let's do my eyebrows. And we're gonna go in with this MAC Fluid Line Brow Gel Cream in True Brunette.
Yeah. I'm just gonna draw on some eyebrows, fill them in.
Yeah. Don't judge me.
Self
That's actually pretty neat. But I'm way too lazy to actually do it. Well, what you do, he's asking me about, you know what? Actually, I bought this to make a video on it, and I never did. Like, I filmed part of it. And I don't know if I ever finished. I think I finished it, and then I just didn't like it. I think that's what happened. But anyways, it's from one of those Korean brands. Where they have like the peel off makeup, Secret Key, that's what it is. The Secret Key self brow tattoo tint pack. And it's just one of those things that you paint it on and then you peel it off like hours later and it tints your eyebrows for like a day or two. Like it worked, it was cool, but that's a lot of effort I'm not willing to put in. Where'd you see a cop?
Well, he was actually in front of me and then like swerved into oncoming traffic and flipped his lights on. Well, I don't know what he was doing, but he...
Maybe he was just hungry.
It could have been because he was kind of like, he's went in towards McDonald's right there with his lights on though. So maybe he was like, I need a chicken sandwich now.
Ice cream!
No, their ice cream machine's always broken. It's McDonald's. Looks pretty.
Mm-hmm. What if I only had one eyebrow, though?
I feel like you would just draw them on like everybody else does.
Yeah, but would you still love me if you had to look at me every time I'm in my natural state with one eyebrow?
I'd love you no matter what.
You hear that? But if he met me and I had something weird like that,
and then like, ugh,
you
girl.
Think we'd be sitting here right now?
Girl, stay away from me.
Girl, what's wrong with your eyebrows?
Oh, look at that. I got somewhere else to be.
I'm gonna go walk my goldfish.
Floppy, the goldfish.
Gotta go walk my floppy dick.
Getting there.
I'm making a statement. This is all I'm doing.
Yeah.
No. Absolutely not. I just lied.
Yeah, I don't think you'd be ballsy to walk out in public like that.
Absolutely not. Maybe if I was really, really hungover. That's like the only way, though. Or if I was, you know, like, current faced, probably wouldn't care.
Screaming at 2 a.m. to get you some Taco Bell. With half an eyebrow. 1.5 eyebrows.
So, who's all excited about the Spyro Reignited trilogy?
I think you are.
I'm very excited.
Never played them.
Dude, it's so much fun. Like, you're gonna play it with me. You should play Crash Bandicoot while I'm not here. And just enjoy yourself.
I don't think I think I only played like the second Crash Bandicoot whenever it was originally out.
Second one's really good.
I think it was the second one. It was the one with the planes and you gotta shoot down the hot air balloon.
That was the third.
Maybe then I only played the third one.
You drive a motorcycle on one part of it.
Yeah.
And then, like, you get to play Coco in certain areas.
I guess so, yeah. You got to ride the...
Jet ski.
Jet ski. There was the tiger. You got to ride the tiger.
Yeah, that's the third one.
Yeah, so that was the only one I ever played.
Surprise, mother... I play video games. Why do you like me? I'm literally a 12-year-old boy.
That's what I like.
You know... Who I, like, want a high five, though.
Who's that?
The man that left society to live as, like, a mountain goat.
I showed you that thing where that guy became a dog, right?
Yeah.
Abomination. Yeah, that's weird.
That's so funny. People are weird, man. No, who am I to say what's weird and what's not? Really, though. You know? Next, I'm gonna go in with this L'Oreal Concealer and Contour palette, whatever, that's been used and abused as well, because actually,
they're gone.
Yeah, I did a whole review on this, like, collection, and I still use these, because I really like them. I don't really, like, the only thing I really use them for, though, is to clean up my eyebrows, and then sometimes I'll cream contour with the, you know, the only contour shade in there. But yeah, I mainly just use it for my eyebrows. Or if I have like a really, really bad zit. Like, a zit right there, but I really don't care.
I've heard all of those words used in sentences before. Still no idea what it means.
Which one?
All the words you said. Contour, cream.
Contour? Literally, in the contours of your face, you know? Like the hollows of your cheeks right here. You're adding like a shadow to that to like, I can't think of words. Exaggerate, like to enhance like your, the natural like shadows and contours that you already have.
Okay.
Good enough for me.
Looks pretty.
When I go to work, most of the time, all I do is go back in with this Too Faced bronzer and a fluffy crease brush. This one happens to be a Kylie brush. I know a lot of people talk mad about her big, like, expensive brush set that was, brush set that was like $300-something and about how it was like way overpriced and how it was only like okay. But her little 5-piece eyeshadow brushes, I actually use those a lot. And I bought them like a year ago.
How long do brushes normally last?
Oh, I've had some of my brushes for years. Like, I'm pretty sure this one's like years old. Let's see. I know. This brush literally has to be like 10 years old. Like, there's no way around it that this brush is not 10 years old.
Flawless face.
If you like buy quality stuff, like it lasts. Most of my brushes, like, I mean, of course I have some cheap brushes, but most of them are like good. So they last like forever. Like this bronzer, for example. Yeah, and all I do is put it in the crease. And that's it. My work makeup is so, so simple. It's not even funny.
No crazy eyeshadows. Anything like that?
No, because like whenever we get up on the box and do dances and stuff, like, one, we're already dancing, and then two, like, we've got the spotlights shining right on us, so it's like we, like, I've, like, poured sweat before. I'm gonna go back in with this broken highlighter.
Anything brighter?
No, I'm gonna take it and highlight my brow bone. And inner corner. No, your waterline is your inner rim right here.
Oh.
Mhm. And then when you
stab yourself in the eye when you do that.
Mhm. And then when you hear tight line, it's your upper waterline.
Learn something new every day. Looks perfect.
Thank you. You're so sweet. Are you just telling me that, or do you really mean it?
No, I really mean it.
Aw, it's so sweet. can't throw it away. I love it so much. It's only like a $5 highlighter, but still, like, that's an entire pan. I can't just throw that away. That's abuse.
I mean, if it lasts 2.5 years like that other thing does.
I mean, sometimes I like to take the highbrow pencil by Benefit Cosmetics and literally just put it in my waterline for a brightening effect.
Have you ever poked yourself in the eye?
Yes, absolutely. I've scraped my cornea with wood from a dull pencil. Sat there and wondered what I was gonna name my CNI dog. The whole 100 or 9 yards, there we go. And for mascara, this is the Physician's Formula Organic Wear. Tati made me buy it, for being honest here.
Made you buy it?
Yeah. She talked about it more than once, so I felt like I should try it. You know, it's fun. Why are you shaking your head?
Because that's a little weird first. I've never seen it that close being done. Also, I'm afraid you might poke yourself in the face or the eye with it.
I mean, I do sometimes. And it hurts. But honestly, we all do it, and it's fine. I think you're more focused than I am.
I've never seen
it. Are you amazed right now?
Yeah, kind of.
That I can comb my eyelashes with product?
I've never seen it done up that close.
And not go blind?
I'd be afraid of, like, stabbing myself with my eyeball.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Promise my background will look better. We just moved in. And for my eyelashes, no, they're not in here, but it's the Eylure Luxe. It's like faux silk or whatever. Wasn't it the Silk Effect? Oh, Mink Effect lashes. There we go. And it's the Opulent Style. And no, they're not in the box because I reuse my lashes. Because why wouldn't I? That's a waste of money. With my Duo Lash Glue. Thank you, Christopher.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Christopher. Christopher? Let me just pick off some of this glue because I'm a trash can. Because I really need to start like soaking these in my cellar water again.
What's that do?
It makes them easier to clean. Like it softens the glue. So it's easier to take off so you can, like, not rip apart your eyelashes. But it's fine. I love eyelashes.
Well, did you get the extension things?
I might. I'm thinking about it. I want to get, before I do anything, though, the first thing I want to get my eyebrows microbladed.
Is that where they take the strings?
No, that's threading.
That's microblading.
Microblading is a form of tattooing on your eyebrows. They numb the area, and then it's not like a tattoo gun, it's like a razor, and they literally like feather on hair. Like I think they put all the ink down and then they like feather it with a razor. It is, that's why it's expensive.
What does the tweezers do? Just make sure they stick?
Just gives you more precision. Do you mind?
She's like, this is
my I wonder time. If that's like picking up. Like, I wonder if they can hear like digging around. Do you guys hear my cat?
She's not worried about your YouTube channel. Yeah. This is my time.
I do have a legitimate question.
For me?
For you and everyone. Well, no, you don't. Well, I mean, you shave like your balls and stuff in the shower. Okay, so do you wash first or shave first?
Like, I wash my balls and then shave them?
Mm-hmm. Or vice versa?
Vice versa.
You shave then wash?
Yeah.
Okay, me too. What about you guys? Do you wash then shave or shave then wash? Because that was a serious question I thought of while I was taking a shower. I was curious. I was like, I wonder if other people do it this way or if they do it the other way.
I could see, like, if you clean shaved, whatever, you could, like, wash first a little bit. But I use, like, a beard trimmer or a trimmer. So I just shave.
Well, I mean, like, even my legs, though, like, I shave those first and then wash.
Do you know? Because I've seen where, like, you wet your legs first, then put whatever, I guess, like, the shower.
Well, yeah, yeah. Like, I mean, I get my body wet because I stand in the shower for 10 minutes contemplating everything before I start anything.
You gotta have a plan.
I just gotta, like, shut my brain down for a minute and just stand there.
Oh. I just go to town with a trimmer.
No, like, the first 10 minutes of my shower is literally me just, like, letting water run through my hair.
I do that after the shave. Normal shower, it's pretty much soaking my entire body, getting the, like, water everywhere. And then it's the hair.
But you guys didn't see this turning into how to shower video.
You gotta get all wet first and lather up.
Ah!
You stab yourself in the eye.
No, it's like my eye got really dry, so it burned for a second. No, then my eyelashes are done.
That's fine.
Huh?
Yes, girl.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, yes.
Yes. For the sake of this video, because whenever I go to work, I typically wear chapstick sometimes, and that's like when I'm at work, just, you know, thinking about chapstick. So for the sake of this video, we're going to put on this Kylie lip gloss in So Cute. Opaque as damn.
Does it dry on matte? That's another thing I've learned by watching your videos.
No, this is a gloss.
Oh.
Who knows what matte means?
It's a nude color, isn't it? You know that too.
I don't like it. I'm like my skin tone right now. I've got major, like, having major, like, 2009 flashbacks right now. With the concealer lips.
2009.
When, like, the whole, like, emo, like, scene kid thing was big. Oh, and exactly. MySpace.
Not 2009.
Or, like, 2007. I don't know. Like
2006.
Okay, I'm younger than you, Christopher.
Because about 2007 is when Facebook actually became open to the public. So... That's when I remember. That's when I got mine.
Christopher.
Alexifer.
I'm younger than you, so my emo friends. We were later. We were a couple years later. Okay.
Couple years.
Yeah. Well, I'm 22, and Christopher here's 30. And sometimes we talk about things, and I make him feel like an old man.
I feel like 30 has jumped to like 40 sometimes.
So this completes my workbook. Hope you guys are excited to have me back. He's excited.
I am.
Why are you excited?
Because this is something you love.
It is. I love, like... Like, it, people don't understand. It literally takes... Like, you can't just, like, record something and then edit it for, like, 10 minutes and then throw it up and expect to have, like, this great video. It takes me, like... hours to edit just one video.
See, I've seen you like editing for a good day.
Yeah, like I will literally spend the entire day editing just because I'm so excited and like want to finish it right then, but I will literally spend the entire day doing it.
We also do all your editing and and filming on your phone, so.
I think I do pretty good to just use my phone. Like, I don't think my quality is, like, terrible considering I do everything on my phone, you know?
Mm-hmm. One day you'll have that fancy setup.
Have you ever watched any of my videos?
I've seen a whole 2 minutes of one video. I feel like I can probably say this now because we are together. It was when we first started.
Oh God, I'm terrified. Are you about to be like, it was because now you're like, I can say this now that we're together.
No. It was, we've probably been hanging out for like a week.
Oh my God, why would you watch it that soon?
Well, I didn't watch it. No. Well, I did watch it, but I was the one that went looking for it.
Who did? I'm like mortified right now.
John went looking for it.
How did John know I had a YouTube channel?
He looked you up and everything and all that stuff came up. He's like the FBI when it comes to like stalking people on social media.
What did he say about it?
Oh, he liked you. He was like, oh, she's got like that country accent and everything. Thought it was cool. So.
See, and I can use my watch as my viewfinder.
There you go.
So, holy shit, we've been doing this for 50 minutes. Alright guys, hit the like button if you like seeing Chris in my videos. But I'm really happy to be doing this again, and I'm gonna keep doing it because I'm in a good place right now.
Yeah.
And nothing crazy's happening. No car wrecks, no arrests, no none of that. It's pretty chill. I got lots of free time because I quit. So after I quit Twin Peaks, I actually did go back to Hooters. And I just quit Hooters again like 3 weeks ago. And now I solely work at Cowboys.
Yeah, I guess it was only 3 weeks. We did it when we first moved in here.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah. All right, guys. I will see you next time.